I know for a lot of family members of mine, the adopted family members, it was hard for them to get out here. So that was our biggest thing with those that could. It was just a present in itself.
Thank you very much.
Really thankful. It wasn't an easy trip. Even for us, it was a long journey down here, but hopefully the next 2 days will be worth it and everyone have a really good time. That's our main concern now. Signed the paperwork in New York, but to make a promise to each other in front of our friends and family, that's the most important thing, because they're all witnesses to it, that we get to share it with everyone. That means a lot to us.
That was this great friend and the first male friend I had, and I would say we were best friends. Or he was my best friend. I don't know if I was his.
She was. For
a very long time before we even started dating, and we did like each other, but
she led me astray so many times.
So many.
I had no idea up until just over a year ago that she had liked me, because she's very good at throwing you off with little comments. And I was like, well, we're always going to be friends, because even if I feel this way, she doesn't. So for quite a while, I was given the runaround. But once she decided that she was going to be honest with me, then I was like, oh, really? Well, I've been feeling this way as well. So then everything started clicking. And once we were dating, it was like we knew that it was going to be something that would last.
I had instantly asked Zac Posen if he would like to design my dress, one being in States, and two, he's just an amazing designer. The best, I feel like. He almost has this haute couture feeling of the States.
He drew the outer skirt.
Beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous.
So 3 o'clock ceremony. On 3:30, they're yours. 7 o'clock, enter into the dining room.
Okay.
You know, thanks people, whatever, when you first come in. And then
when everyone sits down.
Yeah, when everybody sits down.
She's only eating fruit. I know, who told you that?
Yeah, it's really going, and then some of her announced that this is her cake, and then you don't want to just go.
好吧，坐你面前。
OK。
I think mainly the fact that I had no reservations at all. I'm kind of a little bit cynical in general, I think, and it's hard for me to commit to a lot of things because I'm always looking at the good and the bad and weighing things up. But with Coco, I couldn't, the scales were completely tipped in one direction. I couldn't think of anything, any reason why I shouldn't be with this girl as long as she wants to be with me. And we were going to end up together, and here we are, so we're getting married.
Maintenant j'en ai plus besoin, je te remercie.
Okay. Yes, I want the mop.
No, if you could do four clusters, two here and two here, that would be perfect.
It was funny, the photographers were asking me, like, when are you going to start getting ready? I was like, 15 minutes before it's time.
Thank you.
perfect in its own way. Didn't go to plan, but most things don't go to plan. The rain came, and Cynthia, the wedding planner, thought of the great idea of having the wedding on the bridge, which turned out to be, way better than even plan A. So we were.
It was like a collective. I don't know. The whole inspiration seemed like get everything together, just place it around. The fact that we'd been so upset that it wasn't going to work out outside, and then having this new atmosphere. I mean, I was just too excited for words when I saw what was coming up. And then him, I was just so happy to see him. It felt like a different world, though. It didn't feel real at first, but I was so happy that we had our own vows. That was very...
Made it very personal. On this beautiful and joyful day, before this crowd of those that we know and love, I ask you, Coco, to join me in a life together. I know that this will be a life of successes and failures. It will be a life of good times and bad. But through it all, the one constant will be that I'll be right here by your side. When you laugh, I will laugh. And when you cry, I'll cry. And when you sleep at night, I'll be right here by your side. I promise, Coco, that I will be faithful, that I will love you forever, because at last you are bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. And I am so happy that you've chosen me, Coco. I will cherish you as a wife. This is my promise and my pledge to you.
I, Coco, take you, James, to be my husband, to be my best friend, and to be my equal. I promise to cherish this union, to cherish you, to love you with my whole heart, my whole soul, and my whole mind. I promise to honor you, cherish you, care for you, encourage you through the greatest of times and the hardest of times. I promise to bring you joy and to bring you peace. And whenever you're in need of me, I promise to be there. Wherever you go, I will go. And wherever you stay, I will stay. And I promise that only death should make a separation between you and I. And so today, I leave you in your hands. So therefore, I give you my hand, my heart, from this day forth.
It's my happy pleasure to introduce you to this marriage gathering, and from Mr. and Mrs. James Edward
Conran. Coco, to me, is very separate from the personality that people would know. She's very sensitive and sweet and caring, and she loves her family. People that are close to Coco can feel it because she lets it be known. So to me, Coco is like the perfect person. I wish I was more like Coco, and that's why I want to be around her all the time, because I feel like there's a lot that I can learn from her as a person.
And I've seen your flag on the marble arch, and love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah.
She's very generous with her time. She volunteers every week in some way or shape or form. She just recently did the Struck for a Cure. And when someone tells her a story that she feels deeply about, she wants to do something to help and to change. And that's not a quality you find very often. Most people in her position get kind of self-centered, and Coco's not like that at all. She's all about the other person. If you're talking to her, she wants to know about you. She doesn't want to talk about herself.
But remember when I moved in you, and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew is hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Amazing husband, as he's been brother and friend to me for the last 27 years.
And if I love you half as much as I love Coco, you'll have a pretty big spot in my heart. I just feel so privileged to be here. I love you.
Well, we'd just both like to thank everyone for making the trip out here. I know it wasn't easy for anyone to be here. You've all gone to a lot of effort. You all look wonderful, and you're such a credit to us. As I look around the room, I see people that mean a lot to me in my life, and people that have meant a lot to Coco as well. And to see you all interacting and getting along so well together, it came as a bit of a surprise, but really, it shouldn't have been. I want to add, I know there's a lot of people who've taken good care of Coco over the years. She has aunties, mothers, adopted mothers, grandmothers, fathers. There's so many people that have taken an interest in her. Even her agents have taken care of this girl, such good care of her. And I promise you, I will take the best care of her. I won't let you down.
Hallelujah.